Tonight's project starts off, as all the best projects do, with a beer. In this case, it's Half Pint Brewing Stir Stick Stout. They describe it as a medium-bodied coffee stout with notes of dark roast coffee, to semi-sweet chocolate, and classically bright Golding's hops. So this project is to solve a problem that this Dollar Star light kind of solves for me. This light I've got stuck on just above our freezer, and it works okay. The only problem is it uses AAA batteries, no, AA batteries, and it goes through them. And I'm constantly replacing them. So I am going to try and upgrade this light here with rechargeables. Of course, I could just put nickel metal hydride rechargeables in and call it a day, but where's the fun in that? I would rather put a lithium-ion battery in here, put a little recharging circuit in here, and make that work. And since I'm going to do that, I might as well use one of those reclaimed cells that I pulled out of the vape thing a few weeks ago. Nothing better than free batteries, right? So before I get too carried away, I want to just see how much power this thing actually takes at the 4.5 volts that it would be with these three AA batteries in here, and then see whether I want to modify the light at all beyond just putting a different charging system in it, or if I want to actually change the current that it runs at. So we'll first see just how much current it draws, and then we'll make some decisions from there. So at 4.5 volts, turn that on, turn that on. Yeah, that's just as bright as it was. So that's drawing about 300 milliamps. Wonder what happens if I push it to 5 volts. Well, the light hasn't failed, that's a good start. And that's drawing 480, 490 milliamps. That may be a little bit much. The battery should be able to do that just straight up. 4.2 volts is what the battery is maxed out. And, well, actually, let's try that. Let's back this down to 4.2 volts. The light output's not noticeably less. And that's still 300 milliamps. Let's take it down to about 3.5, which is what the lithium battery will be when it's mostly discharged. There's 3.28, 137 milliamps. That's dimmer, but it's still throwing a lot of light, much more than when these are dead. So I think that makes some decisions for me. There we go, lithium ion charge protection boards. The other option would have been, I've got some different boards that have a boost circuit in it, but these ones just put out the battery voltage straight out to the load. So I think that's what I'm going to use, because as we saw, we're not going to go so low that this thing isn't functional. So I've got a few different types of these boards, but the two that are in here that actually have both charge and protection are essentially the same board. Matter of fact, the only difference in them is the connector on them. The older one is the micro USB, and these newer ones are the USB-C. I further think that I'm going to use a little different connector. I think I will use the USB-C connector. I got a few of those. Now, why don't I use just the one with the USB-C connector on it? Well, I'm going to save those for something else. Plus, I don't think it would fit that way in here very well. So what I'm thinking of doing is putting one of these guys in here, kind of like that, and then wire its input to the USB-C connector, which I will just stick on there and poke a hole through the back. First things first, the mechanical bits. And I'm not going to get too fancy with this. I just want to poke a hole in the back of it, and I'm going to hot melt glue this in. Okay, I think that's bigger than it needs to be, which is just about perfect. on these little USB-C boards, we have voltage there and ground there on a pad, and I'm not too concerned about the data pads or anything on the back side. I just need the voltage. So that should be fairly straightforward to pick up off of here. So remember the color code of those wires for later, because I sure aren't going to. The other half of the equation for power coming into this is this board. Originally it was designed to come in through the USB, but as you can see, it also has a plus and minus for the 5 volts in. So that is, you know, how much easier can it get, really? So that ought to light up. Yes, it does. Cool. Okay. Next, I'll just solder the battery onto there. And then I've also got to get the output, which is also the battery, over to here. Actually, I was wrong. The positive out and positive battery are both together, but the negative out and negative battery aren't, because the output on these modules is protected by the DW01 chip over there, which prevents over discharge of the battery. Yeah, this guy here, the DW01A battery protection IC, designed to protect one cell lithium-ion battery pack. It's both an overcharge and over-discharge protection. The over-discharge protection kicks in at 2.4 volts, and the overcharge kicks in at 4.3 and then releases at 4.1 volts. And then the over-discharge releases when the battery voltage gets back up to 3 volts or above. So if it does go into protection, hopefully removing the load will let it come back up again, sort of relax and recover a bit. But if it doesn't, then I'll probably have to go in and just put a little bit of current into the battery directly before it'll release. But that's better than completely trashing the battery and making it totally useless. And this is where it gets a little bit scary, chopping the wires and stripping them and not having any protection available while I'm monkeying with it. But if you're careful, it's not too bad. Before I go any further, I'm going to validate that the black wire is in fact negative, and it is. Okay, always like to check these things, you know. And actually, now that I've got that all unsafe and exposed, I think what I probably should do first is connect the output wires before I connect the battery, just to reduce the risk of me doing something stupid. Probably should have tinned those first, but whatever. I think I will tin these ones though, just to make it go a little bit smoother. It's good practice. Not that that's what I always do, but still, you got witnesses. Maybe it's not a bad idea to follow good practice once in a while. That is that one. I'm going to do these one at a time this time. Just again, to try and be vaguely safe-ish. Well, this is hard to do through the camera. Don't have any depth perception at all. Okay, there should be the battery voltage, 4. Whatever on there. Yeah, 4.0 whatever, good. That gives me a charging light. That's good. And then this should be a little higher because there's a charge going on here. 4.16. Yeah, cool. It's doing the thing. So while I'm waiting for the hot goo gun to warm up, let's just take a peek inside this guy and see where I can tag those wires on easily and relatively painlessly. I think I've done a teardown video on this little light before, several years ago. And if I remember correctly, there's nothing all that exciting inside it. Yeah, it's just literally a cob LED, a resistor, and a switch. So I think what I'll do is I'll just drill a couple of holes here to put these wires through. That should be easy enough to use. And it also makes it somewhat reversible. So I can pull those back out if I want to just go back to AA batteries. I'm not completely destroying the thing, I'm just cutting a few holes in it. Not that I would want to go back. Where's some extra bits of this wire? Will it fit through the holes? Yes, good, I didn't drill too small holes. I'll just jam these guys through here. And jam this in. I'm melting plastic. I'm melting my fingers. Ow. Okay. That worked. This one back here. Ah! Shut the switch off. It'll work, though. That's a good sign. Okay. Now, I'm going to struggle with mechanically getting this thing back together a little bit. There. Now, so, I think, jam that in there. I'll make sure that the wires are accessible so that I can get at them later. Just in case I need them, because I probably will. Uh-oh. Ah, get out of the way. Try not to get glue into the connector face, of course, because that would be bad. Get that vaguely squared up. Doesn't have to be perfect. This is just for at home, you know. I'm probably the only one who's ever going to use it. I'm sure the kids will never think to recharge it. Okay, that hot melt glue is cooled enough to stay in place. But I don't think I'm going to use hot melt on the lithium cell for what should be fairly obvious reasons. I'm going to use this 3W, not quite 3M, heavy-duty mounting tape. It's kind of foamy and thick. I wish I could remember the name for this stuff, but it's essentially a very aggressive adhesive with a thick kind of, not quite spongy, but rubbery sort of texture in the middle of it. I'll just stick that on. I think I'll stick it kind of crosswise. So it's not going to be stuck to very many places, just to those two ribs there, but that's enough. And everything will clear each other, because this is well sunk into there. And this stuff's all well down in there. I should be able to just snap the back on. Didn't get that quite centered. Don't care. That works. I got one of the wires trapped in there. Damn it. I'll fix that later. I'm not too concerned about it right now. But it does actually work. And when I plug in the charging cable. Yeah, it is drawing about 440, 450 milliamps. So that's cool. The charging still works. Now all I have to do is let it finish charging and stick it back onto the ductwork beside the freezer, and we will have our light back again. Well, thanks for watching. I appreciate that as always. A nice simple little project. Nothing too fancy at all, but it's nice to use these super cheap little charging boards, charging slash protection boards, and of course it's nice to use the free vape source batteries that I picked up a while ago. I'm gonna have to keep my eyes out for more of those. Anyway, thanks for watching. Questions and comments down below as usual. I will talk to you later.